This odontotor here is about acidic strength of carboxylic acids. Carboxylic acids are among famous acids of organic chemistry. They can be considered as organic oxoacids. In general, carboxylic acids can be represented as RCOH, where R is an organic group such as an alkyl group or an aryl group. It can also be hydrogen. Their structure is as follows. COOH group, carboxy group or carboxyl group is the characteristic functional group of carboxylic acids. In IUPAC nomenclature, carboxylic acids are named or denoted by adding oic acid or by substitute use of the suffix carboxylic acid. For example, alkane becomes alkanoic acid. For example, methane becomes methanoic acid. Ethane becomes ethanoic acid, and so on. In addition, carboxylic acids can have trivial or non-systematic names. For example, formic acid for methanoic acid. We have HCOH with this structure, which can be called methanoic acid, but it is commonly referred as formic acid. As another example, we have CH3COH with this structure, which can be named ethanoic acid, but it is commonly referred as acetic acid. For carboxylic acids, we can consider acid dissociation reaction as follows. Where the conjugate base RCO- is named carboxylate anion. For example, formate anion for HCO-, acetate anion for CH3CO-. In aqueous solutions, carboxylic acids are not usually strong acids. There are generally weak acids in aqueous solutions. For example, value of pKa of acetic acid is equal to 4.76. While carboxylic acids are not generally strong acids, there are generally weak acids, yet there are much stronger from many other oxoacids, such as alcohols, phenols. In this regard, it is good to consider water as one of the simplest compounds in which hydrogen is bonded to oxygen and it can show acidic behavior. Value of pKa of water in aqueous solution is equal to 14. If we consider this as the base, we can see that carboxylic acids are generally much stronger than many compounds in which hydrogen, acidic hydrogen, is bonded to oxygen. This increased acidic strength can be attributed to the resonance in the conjugate base of carboxylic acids. Carboxylate anions can have this resonance. resonance delocalizes the negative charge between two electronegative oxygen atoms and stabilizes the conjugate base. As a result, acidity of carboxylic acids is strengthened and they become much stronger than some other organic oxo acids such as alcohols and phenols. From one carboxylic acid to another one, value of pKa can change. The acidic strength can change. Like other oxo acids, here also is the electronegativity and inductive effects are usually among major factors in determination and comparison of acidities of these compounds. Yet other factors such as field effects, resonance, intermolecular hydrogen bonds, and so on can also be important. Let's consider examples in this regard. Among the simplest carboxylic acids, we have HCOOH, formic acid, with a pKa of 3.75. CH3COH, acetic acid, with a pKa of 4.76. We have propionic acid, also known as propionic acid, with a pKa of 4.87. We have butanoic acid, also known as butyric acid, with a pKa of 4.83. We have pentanoic acid, also known as valeric acid, with a pKa of 4.83. We have hexanoic acid, also known as caproic acid, with a pKa of 4.85. Based on these examples, we see that the simplest carboxylic acid, formic acid, is about 10 times stronger than the other simple carboxylic acids, such as these ones. Its value of acidity constant is about 10 times greater than those of these ones. This can be attributed to the substitution of the hydrogen by alkyl groups and electron donation by alkyl groups. Alkyl groups can have electron donation by inductive phase. This electron donation, like our previous discussion, decreases acidity and makes the acid weaker. In these carboxylic acids, values of pKa's are not very different. Therefore, we can consider that electron donation ability of their alkyl groups are not much different. In general, with the exception of formic acid, value of pKa of the simple carboxylic acids, such as these ones, in which R is a simple alkyl group, value of pKa is very close to 5. For example, in the range between 4.7 and 5. Here it is is also good to consider carbonic acid, H2CO3, with this structure. Carbonic acid is a diprotic acid. Similar to carboxylic acids, it also has the carboxyl group. Yet it is not common to consider carbonic acid as a carboxylic acid. It is usually discussed in the context of inorganic oxoacids. Carbonic acid in aqueous solution mainly remains in its carbon dioxide form. We have this equilibrium reaction. Whose value of equilibrium constant is equal to 1.7 times 10 to the power of minus 3. It is much smaller than 1, which shows us that carbonic acid mainly remains in the CO2 form. The first acid dissociation reaction of carbonic acid can be written in this way. Value of equilibrium constant for this reaction is about 10 to the power of minus 3.6. Since carbonic acid mainly remains in CO2 form, it is common to combine these two reactions with each other. Which yields the equilibrium constant of this reaction as the product of these values equal to 10 to the power of minus 6.35. For simplicity, it is common to consider this as the first acidity constant of carbonic acid. Since the main reaction in aqueous solutions of carbonic acid is this reaction, as much of carbonic acid remains in its CO2 form. Yet we can see that in fact pKa of carbonic acid is about 3.6, is smaller than these ones. This can be attributed to the electron withdrawing OH group instead of hydrogen or alkyl groups. Yet this effect is not very strong since OH group is not a very strong electron withdrawing group. In addition, other effects such as resonance and orbital or pi interactions may compensate its effect here. Anyway, based on values of pKa's, we can see that carbonic acid with this structure has an acidity close to formic acid and about 10 times stronger than other ones. When electron withdrawal by inductive effects increases, acidity also increases. As a result, by increase of strength or number of electron withdrawing groups, acidity also increases. In addition, decrease of distance between electron withdrawing groups and the carboxy group has a similar result. Therefore, increase of number, increase of strength, or decrease of distance for electron withdrawing groups yields stronger acids, make acids stronger. Let's consider examples in this regard. We have acetic acid with a value of pKa of 4.76. We have iodoacetic acid in which one hydrogen of the methyl group is substituted with iodine atom. It has a value of pKa of 3.18. We have bromoacetic acid with a pKa of 2.9. We have chloroacetic acid with a pKa of 2.87. We have fluoroacetic acid with a pKa of 2.59. We have cyanoacetic acid with a pKa of 2.47. And we have nitroacetic acid with a pKa of 1.48. From acetic acid to nitroacetic acid, the strength of electron withdrawing group increases. As a result, inductive effects become stronger, acidity increases, the acid becomes stronger, value of pKa decreases. This is a good example for the fact that by increase of the strength of the electron withdrawing group, inductive effects increase and acidity increases. As an example for the effect of number of electron withdrawing groups, we can consider the following example. We can consider acetic acid, whose value of pKa is 4.76. We have here monocolor acetic acid or chloroacetic acid with a pKa of 2.87. We have dichloroacetic acid with a pKa of 1.35. And we have trichloroacetic acid with a pKa of 0.66. Here we can see by increase of number of electron withdrawing Cl groups, inductive effects become stronger, acidity increases, value of pKa decreases. As an example for the effect of distance, we can consider this example. For butanoic acid or butyric acid, pKa is equal to 4.83. For chlorobutanoic acid has a pKa of 4.52. Trichloro-butanoic acid has a pKa of 4.05. And 2-chloro-butanoic acid has a pKa of 2.86. From 4-chlorobutyric acid to 2-chlorobutyric acid, the distance of the electron withdrawing Cl group from the carboxy group increases. As a result, its inductive effects becomes weaker. Therefore, here we can see that from 2-chlorobutanoic acid to 4-chlorobutanoic acid, acidity decreases and value of pKa increases. Yet still in 4-chlorobutanoic acid, the Cl group has a small amount of inductive effects, which makes this acid a little stronger than the butanoic acid without any Cl group. These examples show us that by increase of strength of electron withdrawing groups, by increase of number of electron withdrawing groups, or by decrease of distance between electron withdrawing groups and the carboxy group, acidity increases, acid becomes stronger, its pKa decreases, and vice versa. In addition to inductive effects, other factors can also be important. Let's consider an example in this regard. We have maleic acid with this structure. It has 2 carboxyl group. It is a dicarboxylic acid. Values of pKa's here are equal to 1.92 for the first acidity constant and 6.23 for the second acidity constant. Also, we have the fumaric acid with this structure. And with these values of pKa's, 3.02 and 4.38. Here, in the first acid dissociation reaction, maleic acid is about 10 times stronger than fumaric acid. On the other hand, in the second acid dissociation reaction, maleic acid is weaker than the fumaric acid. They have identical bonds, therefore, we expect almost similar inductive effects here. Therefore, why the pKa's are different? Let's consider the conjugate bases. In the first acid dissociation reaction, maleic acid produces this hydrogen maleate. And in the second acid dissociation, we have this. In the case of fumaric acid, in the first acid dissociation, we have production of this. And in the second acid dissociation, we have production of this. For conjugate base of the maleic acid, we can consider intermolecular hydrogen bond in this way. Here, we can have an intermolecular hydrogen bond. The formation of this hydrogen bond stabilizes the conjugate base of the maleic acid. As a result, increases its favor to do acid dissociation reaction, which is reflected in the value of its first pKa. In the first pKa, maleic acid is stronger than fumaric acid. In addition, this intermolecular hydrogen bond stabilizes this species and therefore reduces its tendency to do the second acid dissociation reaction. As a result, the second acid dissociation reaction of maleic acid is weaker than that of fumaric acid. Since for fumaric acid, these two groups are away each other, and therefore they cannot form intermolecular hydrogen bond with each other like that of this one. So here we see that how this intermolecular hydrogen bond results in decrease of first pKa and increase of the second pKa for maleic acid in comparison to fumaric acid. In addition to intermolecular hydrogen bond here, we can also consider field effects. Field effects are intermolecular Coulombic interactions which act directly through space rather than through bonds. For inductive effects, they act through bonds within a chain of atoms. But for field effects, they act directly through space. Experimentally, it is hard to distinguish these two effects, since in many cases they are influenced in the same direction by structural change. Yet, they are usually considered as different effects. Inductive effects are through bonds, while field effects are directly through space. Here we can consider field effects for this species. Here, these two negative carboxylate groups will repel each other. We will have field effects in the form of repulsion here. Here, they are farther from each other. In comparison to these, therefore, here the repulsion is smaller, since they are more away from each other. This repulsion, this field effect here, reduces stability of this species. As a result, it makes the second acid dissociation harder here. So it also contributes to the greater value of the second pKa of maleic acid in comparison to that of fumaric acid. As another example, let's consider some dicarboxylic acids, which have two carboxylic acids. The simplest dicarboxylic acid is the oxalic acid with this structure. And these values of pKa is 1.25 and 3.81. We also have malonic acid as another dicarboxylic acid with values of pKa's equal to 2.85 and 5.7. We can also consider succinic acid, this one, with values of pKa's equal to 4.21 and 5.64. In addition, we can consider glutaric acid, this one, with values of pKa's equal to 4.32 and 5.42. We can also consider this one, adipic acid, with values of pKa's equal to 4.41 and 5.41. For comparison, we can consider formic acid with a pKa of 3.75 and acetic acid with a pKa of 4.76. Let's compare oxalic acid with formic acid. Value of pKa for this one is equal to 3.75, while for this one, the first pKa is equal to 1.25. In the first acid dissociation reaction, it yields this one, CO minus COH, which has a pKa of 3.81. Oxalic acid is much stronger than formic acid in the first acid dissociation reaction. This can be attributed to the substitution of hydrogen by carboxyl group, where carboxyl group has strong electron withdrawal ability. Carboxyl group, as a strong electron withdrawing group, increases the first acidity of oxalic acid in comparison to formic acid. On the other hand, the second acidity of oxalic acid is a little weaker than formic acid. In this one, instead of hydrogen, we have carboxylate anion, carboxylate group. Therefore, we see that here, carboxylate group doesn't have inductive effects in the form of electron withdrawal like that of COOH group, which can be related to its negative charge. due to its negative charge, it cannot withdraw electrons like COH group. It might even have electron donation ability. Here, we can also consider field effect. The conjugate base of this one will be oxalic anion with this structure. And for this conjugate base, between these two negative groups, we will have repulsion, which will act through space. Therefore, it can be considered as field effect. This field effect reduces the stability of this species. Therefore, it reduces the acidity of this one. And therefore, we see that for oxalic acid, the second acidity is much weaker than this one. Here, situation might look suitable for formation of pi interaction between these two CO2 minus groups. Yet experimental results show that this bond, this carbon-carbon bond, can be best characterized as a single sigma carbon-carbon bond with minimum pi interactions. Therefore, we don't need to consider orbital or pi interactions here. Anyway, oxalic acid in its first acidity is stronger than formic acid due to the strong electron withdrawing COH group. On the other hand, in the second acidity, it is weaker than formic acid due to the repulsion between two negative carboxylate anions. Other dicarboxylic acids, for other dicarboxylic acids, it is better to compare them with acetic acid to account for the inductive effects by CH2 groups. We can see that for other dicarboxylic acids, the first acidity is stronger than acetic acid, the second acidity is weaker than the acetic acid. Again, here, we can consider inductive and field effects. Electron withdrawing COH group results in higher acidity for dicarboxylic acids in the first acid dissociation reaction in comparison to that of acetic acid. On the other hand, repulsion between two carboxylate anions in the case of second acid dissociation reaction results in less acidity for the second acidity of these dicarboxylic acids in comparison to acetic acid. Here, for these carboxylic acids, we can also consider intermolecular hydrogen bond. For example, malonic acid in its first dissociation reaction will produce this. Which can have intermolecular hydrogen bond in this way, this one. This intermolecular hydrogen bond stabilizes this species. As a result, it increases the first acidity and decreases the second acidity. So we see that here we can use a combination of inductive effects, field effects, intermolecular hydrogen bonds to compare acidities of these species. In addition, it is good to pay attention to the fact that as these two carboxylic acids get away from each other, as their distance from each other increases, their inductive and field effects on each other also decreases. Therefore, effects of inductive and field effects get weaker and other parameters become more important. This also shows itself in the reduction or decrease of difference between these two pKa values. From malonic acid to succinic acid to glutaric acid to adipic acid, difference between values of the first and second pKa's decreases, which can be attributed to decrease of inductive and field effects of two carboxylic groups on each other due to increase of their distance from each other. Examples such as this one show us that in the case of carboxylic acids, still electronegative and inductive effects are among major factors in determination and comparison of their acidities. Yet other factors can also be important. This is the end of this online tutorial. I hope you find it useful.